Smacking your ankle to test your metabolism does sound like those clickbait ads with the fake symptoms, but it's actually a well-studied medical sign that can even approximate thyroid blood tests. Now, I know it's suspicious it's not on the standard list you'll find of hypothyroidism symptoms, and those lists are useful. I wish I'd reviewed one when I was younger, but the ankle sign might actually be more telling than anything else, even more than the obvious things like watching for weight gain. Now, it's best tested by some of these crazy contraptions researchers have made, but you can get a rough sense of it on yourself. So why would ankle spanking tell us anything useful? It's to look for a muscle movement pattern that happens to be easy to trigger from your Achilles tendon. It's a pattern called Woltman's sign that was first explored a good century ago. For reasons they didn't really understand at the time, hypothyroid muscles can't relax as efficiently as normal people's muscles. And that's something that might trip you up when you do the test if you're used to those usual examples of low and high metabolism, where low metabolism seems like a very relaxed state, and high metabolism seems like a tense, manic burning of energy. But for the ankle test, we're looking for a more subtle kind of relaxation. It's the ability to go from engaged muscles to relaxed muscles very quickly. The faster the relaxation, the more it suggests a high metabolism. So before you start the test, picture the spectrum of relaxation as running from a landing hummingbird instant relaxation that implies a raging metabolism all the way over to a slow, stiff relaxation of a sloth that implies hypothyroidism. Or the even further extreme of rigor mortis, where muscles can't relax because they have no metabolism. As crazy as it sounds, that cellular level inability to relax can be linked to a lot of the symptoms of a low metabolism that seem random at first glance. So, how do we do the test? To start the process, you'll want to grab something that's long and narrow but is still heavy, like a butter knife handle or a big screwdriver or a similar tool, or even a real medical reflex hammer if you've got one. Then you can either cross your leg over your knee, or I think it's easiest at first to hop astride a chair or a couch where your foot can hang freely behind you. But either way, intentionally relax your legs so that your foot's as floppy as possible. And then whip out enough of your ankle to scandalize a Victorian and thump hard across your Achilles tendon. You're looking for that type of automatic kick, like when the doctor tests your knee reflex, except it'll be your foot kicking back and then automatically relaxing to its resting position. But the reflex is hard to trigger consistently, even for doctors, so don't worry if it takes a lot of tries. And for some people, the reflex doesn't happen at all, which might be its own clue of hypothyroidism, or it might mean something else, I don't know. But as long as you're able to trigger some kicks, you can start paying attention to the automatic relaxation after the kick and notice how long that takes, with slower relaxation suggesting slothiness. Now, the studies on this phenomenon try to precisely time the relaxation, but that's hard to do at home. But fortunately, it's easy to just visually compare yourself to the examples I'll show. That might sound a little sloppy, but I agree with this doctor about how easy it is to get an intuitive feel for the type of relaxation that's suspiciously slow. So let's start with the fastest relaxing person I could find, nice and hummingbirdy. He's relaxing back to neutral so quickly that it just looks like his foot is free-falling, like the muscle immediately became a noodle after tightening. Compare that to my speed, a little bit slower to relax, but still floppy and not tense. In the absence of other symptoms, I'm not yet relaxing slow enough to imply hypothyroidism, even though I'm slower than the flash here. So let's see someone that starts to look suspicious, like hypothyroidism might be affecting her muscles. Not that this looks unusual, but if you compare it to mine, you can see her foot softly comes to rest versus my sloppy, faster relaxation. Now let's look at a blatant level of hypothyroidism. You'll need to focus on their calf muscles since the doctor's holding their foot, but notice how it takes almost a full second for the muscle to go from tense to relaxed. Knowing nothing else, odds are decent that this person has significant hypothyroidism. And here's the most extreme example I could find of a person who's in a hypothyroid coma, where you can see her poor muscles are taking several seconds to relax because they're so starved of metabolic resources. I know this might be a scary sight if you're finding hints of hypothyroidism in yourself, but just know that this symptom disappears quickly if you get thyroid hormone meds. So if you can place your own relaxation rate somewhere between these examples, you can get a rough sense of whether your muscles are having trouble relaxing. But I did jump right into the testing without mentioning some important points. In spite of the hard cutoff I drew for hypothyroidism, having a pretty fast relaxation isn't a guarantee you're not hypothyroid. I use myself as an example because I suspect I'm still mildly hypothyroid in spite of not showing the ankle sign. I just think of fast relaxation as a good clue you're not horribly affected. On the flip side, you can have the same slow relaxation of a hypothyroid person due to other conditions, but I think most of them are rare and they're too intimidating for me to try to pronounce. A really fast relaxation probably helps in identifying hyperthyroidism as well, but the difference in timing is pretty subtle, so it's going to be harder to spot, especially since I couldn't find any videos of people that are confirmed to be hyperthyroid. Also, if you notice very fast relaxation, it surprised me to see that anxiety might actually cause that. For convenience, or if you have any limitations that make it hard to get to your ankle, you can also look for the same kind of relaxation problems by plucking your bicep or hitting its tendon. You might even get this unpleasant looking mounding as the muscle tries to relax, and I have found the bicep hard to trigger compared to the ankle. You can also try forearm testing that can even be measured with a device called the Thyroflex for more accuracy, but I get the impression it's hard to find a healthcare office that has one available. It might be worth trying both ankles or biceps or forearms because sometimes they react differently and I don't know why. Your doctor might think you're crazy if you mention this test because it's long been standard to diagnose hypothyroidism with blood work, which you can learn to order without a doctor using some pasty guy's website. But keep in mind this test has an advantage over the standard medical blood tests, because rather than just looking at the hormone content in your blood, it's a test of tissue hypothyroidism. It gives a clue about whether everything in the body is working to support the metabolism that the muscle cells need. If you found this interesting, please tap the like button so people will know this video isn't quite as clickbaity as it looks. And stay tuned for more videos about feeling better with biomarkers, most of which won't ask you to hit yourself with a butter knife.